Hello everybody and welcome back to Season 34 of the Pokemon Cup Series. Today we're here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway for the running of the Foxwoods Resort Casino 301. On the poll today we have the number 34, excuse me for a sec, right here now. The number 34 of Diego Yepes starts on the poll today. On the outside will be the number 17 of James Richardson. Row 2 has John Andrews in the 9 and Cullen Francis in the 1. Row 3 will have Grant McKee and Eli Bright. Row 4 with Sebastian Cucullon and Ethan Wickenhauser. And rounding out the top 10 is Daniel Bouchard and our winner from Sonoma last weekend, Rich Roy, as he tries to go for his third win of the season here in the Magic Mile. Let's take your trackside now for the command to fire up the engines in the Foxwoods 301.
Drivers, start your engines!
All right, boys, just like we talked about in the meeting, what we're going to pay off for today is patience and consistency. Good, smooth racing on the racetrack, and that's what'll take us up to the front. We'll be there at the end of this thing.
It'll be a 30-lap race around the Magic Mile here in New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Diego Yepes will lead the field to the green. And here we go, the Foxwoods 301 is underway with the green flag from New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Contact with the wall by John Andrews, and now there's a crash in the back. Daniel Bouchard, a pileup has happened in turn 4. We saw Daniel Bouchard getting held up, and a couple more cars piled up too. And they'll race it back to the line. It looks like Yepes is going to lead to the yellow flag. I'm hoping that they slow down in time. Looks like they will slow down in time. Just cleared the track just before the leaders were going to cross the start finish line. So no need to worry about the damaged cars affecting the leaders. Let's look at what happened. Right here, do you see Roger Ray is pressing the 96 into the wall and they both spin and Igor Barreto got taken out by the two car of Igor Barreto taken. Brandon Tharp made some contact. And then everybody started to pile up. We see Romanuk, Priya McShane, the Gatlin Downey, Christian Vargas. Cars held up there in the near turn 1. And that's what brought the first caution of the race. Still a ways to go here in New Hampshire. We just got underway. And Diego Yepes is out in front right now here in New Hampshire. McShane's the only one that's down a lap. So the wreck did not take any drivers out. That's good. Anyway, gonna go back to the green flag here on this next lap with the leader, Diego Yepes. And here we go back to the green flag in New Hampshire Motor Speedway. Here comes Grant McKee for third place. Gonna move over the one car. That's for third. Another caution, and this time it's for Joseph Romanuk. McKee's able to get third place before the yellow. Joseph Romanuk has spun again. His bad luck continues here in New Hampshire. Let's look back at it. Let's look at the replay. And Romanuk, he was hit by the 51 of Gatlin Downey. And the 10 of Brianna Russell got a piece of the 92 and went into the grass. And that's what the caution was out for, as Romanuk got a little too held up there. Russell's on the apron. I hope she didn't cause any trouble. Ooh, boy. Almost getting on the 20 of Peter Onjak there. But the 10 able to save the car and not wreck out the field. So, glad that they didn't wreck out the field in this situation. Race continues here in New Hampshire Motor Speedway. A crazy wreck fest now brewing up here in New Hampshire. New Hampshire has a ton of wrecks for whatever reason, but Yepes is going to be the leader again on lap 12 with the green flag waves. Look at James Richardson, he might actually have a chance on the lead. Oh man, Yepes is really trying to get on that high lane and get that run. Looks like Cullen Francis wants third place back, and he will get third place back. First time we've been clean and green for this run here today. Two cautions to start the race, and now there's a third caution. Christian Vargas and Patrick Smith. It looks like Yepes is going to hold on for the lead again here in New Hampshire. So here's what happened to Christian Vargas' car. There you see a three-wide battle with Patrick Smith, Don Duth, and Donovan Duth that didn't go so well as they make contact and Vargas goes around with Smith and Duth that also getting taken out. So that's the third caution of the day. I'm surprised these wrecks are small here. We don't normally see small wrecks pulling out more cautions, but surprisingly, there have been. And Rowe and Vargas are done for the day. I guess Rowe had a problem. I didn't even see Rowe in the last cautions. So I guess Rowe might have had a problem and unfortunately has to end his day. McShane is down to one lap again, like I mentioned earlier. But we're going back to the green flag in New Hampshire. 13 laps left here and the magic mile. And Francis and Richardson battle it out for second place. This has been all about Diego Yepes today. He's been holding on to the lead for a long time. But as you all know, anything could possibly happen here in New Hampshire. We get another green flag run here again. Let's hope it stays that way for the rest of the way. Race. There's Evan Hunter, the other two-time winner, along with Rich Roy. They're battling together, by the way, for 9th and 10th. Roy and Hunter, both with two wins each. Both are obviously going to be big contenders to compete for the title. Yepes just pulls away from second. I mean, this car, he is just on fire today. Started on the pole, and he's been dominant ever since. There's Cullen Francis. Look at the run he got on the bottom lane. 10 laps to go in New Hampshire. Still trying to make a pass on Richardson. He might try to draft him a bit. John Andrews running pretty well as well in the fourth spot. Here's Ethan Wickenhauser making up the rest of the top five. Ooh, a little contact in the wall, and here comes the one. Oh, look at that. John Andrews, sneaky move on the one. And he's going to get Francis. That's for third. And Graham McKee is going to try to get in the top five with a pass on the 78. And Andrews is up third place. Cars are smashing the wall now. That might be a difference maker. Andrews, it's his turn for second place. He's going to get second. Andrews is moving up to the ranks. And here comes Richardson. He wants to fight back. He's got the bump from the 11 of Grant McKee. And he's going to get second place back. Andrews is in the wall. bound for second, Bruin, while the 34 just pulls away. And Richardson is still second, and now he needs a miracle. Hopes for a yellow flag to come out before four to go. That way he'll have a chance to catch up to the 34, and it would come down to a one-lap showdown. Well, not anymore now. Now the next caution is going to force overtime. I'm sure Richardson does not want the outside lane in case of overtime. He's still just going to try to reel in the 34 on his own. Five to go in New Hampshire. There's still the possibility of an overtime finish. We've had three cautions today, so we might see a fourth, and that might bring us to overtime. Yepes' lead has built up to almost more than 2 seconds. But we haven't seen drivers pit yet, so we might see pit stops at the very, very end. Yepes is hoping that he has enough fuel to finish. Four to go in New Hampshire, and their car is pitting. So there's going to be pit stops at the very end of the race. Oh boy, this is going to be a lot of fun. Let's see if Yepes is going to pit right now. He's not. But Grant McKee will pit with three to go. Now it's going to come down to pit strategy. Caution's out! Ryan Butcher just went around. Ryan Butcher just went around with the 78 of Ethan Wickenhauser. Wow, what a twist. And now it looks like Yepes might want to stay out and keep the lead for overtime. If he can make it on fuel. And he does with two to go. So it's going to come down to overtime in New Hampshire. Can you believe it? Does Yepes have enough fuel to finish off the rest of the... to be the leader in overtime? It looks like he will. So he's going to be having enough fuel to lead the pack in overtime, the two-lap dash. Oh my goodness. Now it looks like the race is wide open again. So with two laps to go, it's going to come down to who will win it here in New Hampshire. You don't want to miss the finish. Alright, we're back here in overtime in New Hampshire. Two laps with no cautions. We'll see if Diego Yepes can hold on for the race win. He has led every single lap so far from the pole. Now he's going to have to face a two-lap challenge in overtime and see if he can hang on for the win. Here we go. Pace car comes down pit road. It's going to be the two-lap overtime dash to the finish. And the green flag waves here in New Hampshire with two to go. Oh wow, four wide for second. And oh boy, contact. Rich Roy clears second. They make contact. Andrews drops way back, and that might be what Yepes needed. Coming to the white flag with one lap to go. There's a crash in the back. Canario spins. 95 is taken out too. Diego Yepes is gonna wrap up his dominating day with a win. Final corner for the 34, and he's gonna do it. Diego Yepes is gonna take the checkered flag and win the Foxwoods 301 at New Hampshire. What a win for Diego Yepes. He finally wins again. And the magic mile, it was a crazy finish. Came down to the final two laps, but Diego Yepes at last wins again. He beat out the last winner, Rich Roy, so two winners in the top two. What a finish for the 34 team. A big win for Diego Yepes. They have done it again. Wow, another win for the Front Row Motorsports team. They've done the magic. They've made magic again in the Magic Mile. Nine races are in the books, and Diego Yepes adds his name to the playoff driver list. And here are the rest of the results on the screen. As you see here, only two cars out of the race because of the wreck that happened on the last lap of the race. So Diego Yepes wins New Hampshire. We will see you guys next weekend at Chicagoland. All three series will be running at the Chicagoland Speedway, and you don't want to miss a single minute of it. So we'll hope you'll join us for our next race at Chicagoland. We'll see you there.